A very good afternoon to all of you. We are from the project OER repository using DSpace from the FRJ group. Now, Shreya will begin with the presentation.
Motivation. First, we need to know the importance of OER. OER is important because it provides affordable material to students and faculty that can be used for learning, teaching, and many other purposes. Second thing is that collaborative community generate article. That content can be provided to us via DSpace, which act as repository for us. So, what is OER? OER is free and openly licensed educational material that can be easily accessible to us. Before understanding the mapping of collaborative community and DSpace, first we need to understand the structure of collaborative community. Collaborative community consists of communities, group and resources. A system can have 0 to n communities. Each community can have 0 to n groups. And communities and group can have 0 to n resources.
So first we have, so for the OER, we use the DSpace as a software. So these are the following features of the DSpace which motivate us to the use DSpace as a OER software. So first thing is that it is OER, open source, and second that thing that we can able to customize the metadata according to our need. And the third is that it is due to the better look and easy customization, we can we are motivated to use DSpace as our OER repository software. And this is a structure of the DSpace. I'm going to explain it because in the next few slides we are use this structure for the mapping of the DSpace and the collaborative committees. So in the DSpace there is a communities, subcommunities, collection and items. So there can be the system can have 0 to n number of communities, and communities can have 0 to n number of subcommunities, and it can be up to the nth level, means subcommunities. So in the second is collection belong to a community or subcommunities, and all the items or the resources, articles are inside the collections only. So in the DSpace, we are using version 6.2 to archive all the content published by the collaborative communities. So we are fetching the content from the collaborative communities and storing it in the DSpace. And the second, we identify all the metadata according to the need of the resources published by the collaborative communities. And last, we use the APIs to communicate with the DSpace. We identify all the APIs and activate the APIs of the DSpace. And we tested all the APIs and the different format what are the required for the posting APIs. Third, last, we will experiment with the DSpace that of containerize it. And we set up two containers, first for the DSpace development environment and all its dependencies, and the second is for the database. Whole system is running using the Docker Compose, and the DSpace development environment container consists of the Tomcat server, DSpace, and its dependencies. So the mapping between the collaborative community and DSpace is explained by one of my.
Well, now we know the main three components of our project, that is collaborative community, DSpace, and the next app which we have created in order to map collaborative communities to DSpace. Well, as you can see in the diagram, for the creation of community in collaborative communities, we need to create community and collection in DSpace. Similarly with resources, suppose a resource is created in the collaborative community, a corresponding item needs to be created in DSpace. Same goes with groups and resources which are present in a particular community in collaborative communities. Moving on, how did we achieve this mapping? So we decided to create our own separate Django app which would facilitate this mapping. As you can see on the left hand side, we have the collaborative community. In the middle, we have the DSpace X Django app, and on the right side, we have DSpace. So our DSpaceX Django app uses RESTful APIs in order to get the information from collaborative communities. Information is received in terms of JSON format, and this information can be of creation of communities, sub-community groups, or articles in collaborative communities. So when our app works, it uses GET requests in order to fetch the articles that are published, that are in the published state in the collaborative communities. Once this article is fetched, the article that is fetched is in the JSON format to an XHTML to PDF converter. Now what this basically does is significant by its name. It converts the article into PDF format. Why did we choose PDF format was because there would be consistency in the articles which we would be storing and supplying to DSpace. So these fetched articles are then passed to a PDF converter. When the conversion to PDF process is complete, the articles which are in PDF format are then posted to DSpace using post requests. And these articles are posted into DSpace. Now DSpace has two functionalities. One is the archiving functionality and the next is the search functionality. So details about the app which we created will be told by Srujan.
So for effective communication between the collaborative communities portal and the DSpace, we created a new app, the DSpaceX apps. As it mentioned in the architecture, our app simply takes the articles in JSON format and posts them into DSpace. So it does so by making use of the REST APIs, which are already provided in the collaborative communities. By calling these APIs, we simply get all the communities, community articles, groups, and groups articles in the JSON format. And we get those articles that were published or communities that were created a day before. So for example, if I'm running this app on 6 June 2018, it will fetch all those content that was created on 5th June 2018. So going into the details, the DSpaceX app was created in Django, and it mainly does three things. The first is fetching content from CC, collaborative communities, that is done through GET requests. Secondly is converting it into a PDF format. So all the JSON data that we get is converted according to however we want. The placements on the PDF can be done according to our needs. And we use the XHTML to PDF library for this, which is a very handful one when working with Python. And the last one is sending the PDF file onto DSpace. So for sending the PDF file, we also have to send the cookies with it because DSpace needs authentication every time. So post request sends the PDF along with the cookies every time. Now this is an example. On the right hand side, this is the PDF article that we saved on our machines locally currently. This article fetches this JSON content from the collaborative communities. And as you can see, there are article ID, there is a title, and all these are mapped into the PDF file. So technologies used are Django, requests, which are useful for handling HTTP requests, which is the core of what we are doing. We are transferring data using HTTP requests. And the last one is XHTML to PDF, that's for conversion. Now Richit will explain unit test. And also the links for DSpaceX GitHub is there. We've added it here.
Well, once we had made our intermediate system, that is DSpaceX, we now wanted to test our system. So we performed unit testing, which was successful for each and every method we run the unit testing for. Some of the methods which we tested were home test case, create community test case. Create community test case basically tested whether the community which is created in collaborative community is being successfully created in DSpace, and a sub-community as well should be created. Create group test case does the similar functionality, but just the community is replaced by a group. Community resources test case, community resources means that the articles which are generated in collaborative community, and the group resources test case does the similar functionality. The next, we performed Selenium testing for the next group, that is the content tools team, and the Selenium testing for our web app was done by recommendation team. Well, the future scope of this project is we have basically two things that we could have done or we can do in the future. The first thing is that the system is not yet 100% solid if many requests are sent to it, because efficiency depends upon how we gather the data. So one thing which can be implemented is that all the data and all the resources that are being fetched from the collaborative community can be intermediately stored in a RabbitMQ or a queue-like structure so that it will be reliable and efficient, so that that information is not lost in between. The next thing is that the intermediate app needs to run it for a particular period of time, after a particular period of time. So automation is needed for that. So what we have previously thought was that the system which we had intermediately created will run once in every 24 hours. So as mentioned by Srujan, if the system runs on 6th of July, it will fetch all the data and all the resources that that were created in the collaborative community on 5th of July. And similarly, well, these are the references. Thank you.
So what if a collaborative community decided to delete an article?
Currently, there is no any option for deleting the articles, published
articles. Yeah, the articles are published. When reputation system presented that, if an article is published and somebody reported that, correct, then it might be taken down. What will happen in that case?
So currently we are not integrate the API, but there is an API in the DSPS for the deleting of the content in Summit.
No. I am not saying. So basically what you are doing in DSPS, you are basically collecting all the resource, all the articles which are being published by collaborative communities, and you are managing them, because DSpace is all about managing the content, correct? So what will happen then? So if, okay, that is not being handled, but we need to take care of that.
DSpace is a...
Yes, yes.
So
okay.
DSpace provides archiving functionality, so it would be apt only that all the articles which have been published till now are there in DSpace, irrespective of whether those articles are
so
it would prove to be useful for every version of that article to be presented in DSpace.
So you have not
handled it. We have not handled it. Thank you.
So is it possible?
Yeah.
So now you have worked on DSpace, correct? You have worked on the APIs, libraries, and everything. Is it possible to automatically delete that?
Yeah, if CC sends us a request that if it sends us a flag or anything, then we can just add an if case for deleting it.
Okay.
It's simple.
Okay. I see. Good. Okay.
So
thank
all
you.
The cases just can just be handled if they send different requests, so we can add different things for that.
Okay. Thank you.